what's up guys, Zain here, and welcome to my new channel. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about 5 iPhone settings that you may want to turn off on your iPhone. Alrighty, let's get this party train rolling. But first, that's good coffee. Prior to the current iOS 15 update, whenever you received an incoming call, it would take over your entire screen. Was it disruptive? Definitely. But it got the job done. Apple then changed it to a banner style notification. So now, whenever you receive that call, it will show up as a small banner notification on the top of your screen. Well, this is good, because now you can keep using your phone and it's a little less disruptive. However, I don't know about you, but there have been multiple occasions where I've nearly missed a call because I dismissed the notification as something that didn't require my immediate attention. So here's how we can change it back to a full screen where it can grab your attention. Select Settings, scroll down to Phone. Once you select Phone, select Incoming Calls and change it from Banner to Full Screen. Apple has made a lot of changes to Safari. One of the major changes you'll notice is that the address bar is now on the bottom of the screen. The idea is to simplify reachability. By moving the address bar to the bottom of the screen, it's easier to reach the buttons for an effortless browsing experience. I personally prefer it at the current state. However, some people might still like it at the top. Here's how you can change it back. Load up Safari and navigate to a web page. In my case, I'm gonna go to apple.com. Once the website loads, select the AA icon on the address bar and select the first option on top, which says Show Top Bar. That should take it to the top. To bring it back to the bottom, select the AA icon again and select the bottom option, which is Show Bottom Tab Bar, and that should take it back down. Next stop, Background App Refresh. This is a setting that allows apps to run in the background of your iPhone, even when you're not using them. With this setting enabled, your apps will constantly keep refreshing their content. Turning this setting off will definitely give your battery life a boost. However, this doesn't mean that you won't receive those important notifications from your social media apps or your sports scores or what have you. It just means that whenever you open up an app like Facebook, the newer posts will load then. Here's how we can customize this feature. Go to Settings and select General, select Background App Refresh, then select Background App Refresh again, and select Off. That should turn off Background App Refresh. Rolling on to protecting your mail activity. Now to understand this feature a little better, let's talk about those pesky little things called tracking pixels. As the name implies, these are tiny little pixels that are embedded in the body of your email. Now they could be anywhere from the white space to a graphic of an email and are practically undetectable. Despite appearing as nothing, these tracking pixels capture a lot of data about you. From your operating system to your screen resolution, they can even tell you how, when, and where you opened up this email, or whether you clicked any links in it, or whether you forwarded this email to any of your contacts. Enter Mail Privacy Protection. Now, there's not much to this feature from a user's perspective, but once you enable this bad boy, a lot of fairly complex things happen in the background. Per Apple, Mail Privacy Protection hides your IP address and downloads remote content privately when you receive a message. These measures help conceal your actions and your identity. Without these safeguards in place, senders can gain valuable information about your activities and location. It is important to note that Mail Privacy Protection is a feature of the default iOS Mail app. Users opting to use third-party email apps won't be able to utilize this feature. Go to Settings, then select Mail, then select Privacy Protection, and toggle on Protect Mail Activity, and you're all set. After you enable Mail Privacy Protection, you're all set. Just let it do its thing in the background, and you can check your email without worrying whether your data is being harvested without your knowledge or consent. Alright party people, so let's take this setting straight to our last stop, privacy. Privacy is something that's really important to me personally. It's the first thing that I take a look at on any app or device that I use. Now, Apple has given you a lot of options to fine-tune these settings to your liking. Let's take a look at a few. Now, the first thing that I want to talk about in this section is location, location, location. You want to fine-tune these settings to match your needs and only allow these apps to have access to your location on a need-to-know basis. The keyword that we're looking for is always. So most of the apps don't need to constantly track your location, such as your banking app. It doesn't need to track your location all the time. The only time that I can think of that it needs your location is if you're looking for a branch or an ATM nearby. Other than that, not really. So most of these settings can be either be turned off altogether or just changed to while you're using the app. Same goes to all the other features such as camera, microphone, or Bluetooth. You can customize which apps need constant access to these things. While you're at it, go back to privacy settings and tap on Apple Marketing and turn off personalized ads. This won't make you receive less ads, but it'll definitely make advertisers have less information about you. Next up, tracking. Now, companies like Facebook really hate this feature. It's basically, do you want an app to be able to track what other apps you use or what websites you visit? Not really. So the next two features that I want to talk about are paid features for iCloud Plus users, but are totally worth paying for. The first one is Private Relay. This kind of acts like a VPN, which means your internet traffic is sent through Apple's proxy servers, where it strips out your IP address and then assigns you a random one. So now whenever you visit a website, they get that random IP address and it's not easy to track you. The next one is Hide My Email. This service basically allows you to create unlimited mask emails. So the next time you have to provide an email address to sign up for a service, you don't have to give your real one. And you can customize this to your liking. So the next time you start receiving too many unwanted emails or spam messages, you can simply turn off this email. The last one that I want to talk about very quickly is how to generate a privacy report. Once activated, it will record how apps use your data for the next 7 days. The report entails basically how these apps access and use your data, from your microphone to your location to even your internet history. So these are a few features from the privacy option. To be honest though, this section is so wide enough that it's hard to cover in a short segment like this. So maybe it requires a video of its own. Stay tuned for that one. Well, there you go, folks. So if you have made it this far, then thank you so much for watching. And do go ahead and smash that like and subscribe button because it does help out. And you can also follow me on Twitter or Instagram. So, till next time, peace.